Hi, this is Roger Groh with Groh Asset Management. Today we're here to talk about penny stocks. Those are the companies that sell for less than a dollar. How do you trade those types of companies? Well, carefully is the answer. Frequently, that group has been full of fraud and deceit and problems. And as you research it, you will see an awful lot of notations about the Securities and Exchange Commission coming down on businesses or underwriters involved in the penny stock area. Why? Well, either the companies have been too small and haven't been able to handle the growth, or they just lied. Either or, the SEC has been heavily involved in that sector. But that's not to say that all penny stocks are that way. Frequently, larger companies which have gotten into financial trouble sell at very inexpensive prices. And you will see them come up as you begin to do screens to identify all companies that sell for less than a dollar. Okay, how to trade them? Well, they're really not any different from any other company. However, you will find big spreads between bid and ask typically. So if you're willing to pay 80 cents today on the ask and have it be 40 cents 30 seconds later, you can just enter orders and you'll get your shares. But the value of your shares makes shrink considerably. However, if you use limit orders or you have discussions with the traders, there may be a way to whittle it, meaning the next time somebody comes into that stock where they're looking to exit a position, if a trader knows that you're a potential buyer, maybe they'll call you and tell you that there's a seller and perhaps they'll be willing to work with you. Also, in the large mutual funds, which deal somewhat in the penny stock area, they may want to do a trade off the board. And if you're very interested in a specific company, it might be worth calling the manager or trader of that specific fund, telling them that you're willing to be a buyer. And maybe they can do it off the board a little bit cheaper. Commissions are made two ways. Number one, on a per share basis. And then number two, the spread between the bid and the ask. So be careful about that. It can get very expensive to deal in penny stocks. Remember, if you bought it at 20 cents on the ask, and it's only worth 10 cents on the bid, yeah, it's only a dime, but you just took a 50% loss in that stock. Hope that helps. I'm Roger Groh of Groh Asset. Be very careful.